start question number 54. Following is the balance sheet of Akash Limited as at 31st March 2020, and we need to prepare cash flow statement. Current year and previous year both values are given here. Share capital will be recorded in financing activity. Reserve and surplus operating. Long-term borrowing will be recorded under financing activity. Trade payables will go in operating. Property, plant and equipment, tangible assets are given. So, dear children, where it will go? It will go in investing activity. Also, non-current investments are recorded in investing activity. Current assets, under current assets, inventory is given, which will go in operating, trade receivable operating, and cash equivalent will go in proper cash and cash equivalent head. Okay, let's see what else is given. So, notes to account is also given. In reserve and surplus in 2021, now we have loss of 425, and in previous year we have loss of 537,500. It means this year we have earned profit, है ना? Let's see. It will go in operating activity. Debentures will go in financing activity, but 12% rate is given. It means we need to calculate interest on debenture. Let's see what is given in adjustment about interest on debenture. Then additional informations are given. First additional information is given. Debentures were issued on 1st January 2021. It means we need to calculate interest for 9 months and then for 3 months. So first working note we will prepare for interest on debenture. Then second, machinery costing 5 lakh on which depreciation was 1 lakh 75, sold for 3 lakh 75 thousand. It means one working note we need to prepare for machinery account. Okay. Depreciation charge during the year is given 2 lakh. Okay. Non-current investment were sold at a profit of 20%. Non-current investment were sold at a profit of 20%. It means we need to prepare account of non-current investment also. So children, first I will prepare these three working notes, है ना? So let's begin. Question number 54. Working note number one. First, let us see how to calculate interest on debenture. So pay attention carefully. Interest on debentures. So you can see in the beginning, the debentures were of 625,000. 625,000. Okay. And in adjustment, it is mentioned that debentures were issued on 1st January. It means up to 9 January, we have only 625,000. So we need to calculate interest on debenture 12%. So 12% means 12 by 100. And for 9 months, because up to 9 months there is no change. Plus, now what happened? Now after 9 months, some debentures are issued, and now the total debentures are of rupees 7,50,000. So now the interest will be computed on 7,50,000, 12% for remaining month. So 9 months. Is already interest we have already calculated for 9 months, so only 3 months are left in 1 year. So in this manner we will compute. So let me compute 625,000 into 12%, okay, and into 9 by 12, it is equal to 56,250 plus, let me calculate this one also, 7,50,000 multiply by 12% into 3 by 12. So it is coming 22,500. So let me add both of them, 22,500 plus 56,250. So it is coming 78,750. So this is interest on debenture, our first working note. Okay, dear children. So let me prepare second working note. In this question, we need to prepare machine account also, machinery account, debit side, credit side. From where do we start machine account? Machine account starts from debit side. to balance brought down, what do we write? We write opening balance. Let's see how much opening balance is given of machine. It is given 12,50,000. है ना, opening balance of machine tangible. So 12,50,000 is written in the debit side. Then closing balance is also given here, 17,25,000. So we will write closing balance also by balance carried down. By balance carried down, 17,25,000. 17,25,000. In this question, in adjustment, na current year depreciation is also given, 2 lakh rupees. Depreciation charge during the year, 2 lakh rupees. So current year depreciation we will record by depreciation, 2 lakh rupees. Okay, and in adjustment it is mentioned that machinery costing 5 lakh on which depreciation was charged 1,75,000. Okay, so let me explain here. What is the cost of machine? Cost of machine was 5 lakh. Okay, and depreciation was charged, total depreciation. So that is accumulated depreciation was charged 1,75,000. 1,75,000. So the book value which is remaining, that is 3,25,000. So this is the book value of machine now. Okay, and it is sold for 3,75,000. Sold for 3,75,000. So machine of 3,25,000 is sold for 3,75,000. What does it mean? It means this is the profit of ₹50,000. So gain on sale of machine is 50,000. Okay, so in this manner we have computed. So machine is sold for 3,75,000. So we will write in credit side by bank 3,75,000. And there is a gain on sale of machine. Gain will be recorded in debit side to statement of profit and loss. This is gain on sale of machine. That is 50,000. All points are over. Anna, let me do the total and take out from where difference is coming. So difference is coming in debit side, isn't it? So let me do the total. So it will be 5,75,000 plus 17,25,000 is equal to 23 lakh. 23 lakh. And let me take out the difference. 23 lakh minus 13 lakh is equal to 10 lakh. So 10 lakh is remaining in debit side. If 10 lakh is remaining in debit side, what does it mean? It is, we write it to bank account, but it is purchase of machine. If balance remain in debit side of machine account, what does it mean? It means it is purchase. I hope it is clear to everyone, this working note. We need to prepare one more working note in this question, working note number 3. That is for non-current investment, hai na? So we need to prepare non-current investment account. Remember, dear children, if anything is mentioned in adjustment, so it is always better to prepare account, hai na? So let's start. Non-current investment account starts from debit side. So let's see what is given in the question. Come back to the question. Then we see in the question, the opening balance is given 5 lakh. So we write to balance BD. To balance brought down 5 lakh. Closing balance is also given. Closing balance is given 3 lakh. So we write in credit side to balance carried down 3 lakh. To balance carried down 3 lakh. Now let's see what else is given in the adjustment. In adjustment it is mentioned that current investment were sold at a profit of 20%. So it is sold, some of the non-current investment is sold. So when we sell, where do we write? We write in credit side. And what we write? We write bank account, by bank account. And this is what? Sale. Okay, and it is also mentioned in the adjustment that we were sold at a profit of 20%. Where do profit comes? Profit come in debit side. So we will write to statement of profit and loss. So this is the information which is given in this question, and we need to compute statement of profit and loss and sale. So how to calculate? There is one simple information which is given. Were sold at a profit of 20%. We know, dear children, that cost plus profit is equal to sales. So in this question, if we assume that cost is X, the profit will be 20% of X. 20% of X means X by 5. If we solve, what we get? X plus X by 5 is equal to 6X by 5. It means sales is 6X by 5. Sales is 6X divided by 5. And profit is X by 5. Profit is X by 5. And according to equation, if we see, debit is always equal to credit. It means if we solve this equation, 5 lakh plus X by 5, which is debit side, total of debit side, is equal to total of credit side. 6X by 5 is, this is the total of credit side, plus 3 lakh. Now let us continue this equation. Let me see what we get. So when we change the sides now, it becomes 6x by 5 minus x by 5 is equal to 5 lakh minus 3 lakh. Okay. And when we solve this now, 6x we take LCM. So it will come 5, and 6x minus x is equal to 5 minus 3, 2 lakh. Okay, dear children, so it will be 6 minus x, 5x divided by 5 is equal to 2 lakh. And when we solve it now, what we get? 5x is equal to 10 lakh. 5x is equal to 10 lakh, or it means x is equal to 2 lakh. And what is x, dear children? X is cost. We have seen here, cost is X, so profit will be X by 5. So what will be profit? If cost is 2 lakh, the profit will be 20% of 2 lakh. 20% of 2 lakh is 40,000. So cost plus profit is equal to sales, yes or no, dear children? So 2 lakh plus 40,000 is equal to 2 lakh 40,000. So it means by using this, we can understand profit is 40 and sales is 2,40,000. So in place of profit, we can write 40,000, है ना? 40,000, and in place of sales, we can write 2,40,000. In this manner, we have computed 2,40,000. So you can see 3 plus 2, 5,40,000. 5,40,000, the total is same. Where do we write sale? 2,40,000. The sale will be recorded in investing activity. And gain on sale of investment is recorded in operating activity. Isn't it or not? So both these points are needed. So let's continue. Let's prepare cash flow statement. Cash flow statement. Okay. We start with first activity, cash flow from operating activity. Cash flow from operating activity. From where do we start? First we write surplus, and we have seen the surplus in this question. Earlier there was loss of 5,37,500, now loss of 4,25,000. So when we take out the difference, we will get profit. Yes or no? 5,37,500 minus 4,25,000. So now loss is reducing, it means it is profit. Loss is reducing, so it means it is profit by 1,12,500. 1,12,500. We need to add some appropriations. Let's see in this question it is given or not. Appropriations, huh, dear children. Dividend is not given. Okay. Transfer to reserve is also not given. Reserve is also not given. Okay, so there is no appropriation given here. Even provision for tax is also not given in this question, huh? So okay, then directly we add non-cash expenses. Under non-cash expense, what do we write? First, we write depreciation of current year. Depreciation of current year is given in the adjustment. We have seen it is given 2 lakh rupees. Now let's see, is there any intangible assets given in the question? Intangible assets are not given. It means there is no amortization, hai na? Then we write what we add. We add non-operating expenses. Non-operating expenses. Under non-operating expenses, let's see what is given. Interest on debenture we have computed here, dear children, 12%, huh? So that interest on debenture will come. Interest on debentures. We have computed interest on debentures in the first working note. Interest on debenture 78,750. Okay. So we write 78,750 interest on debenture, and then there is no other non-operating expenses. Yes, and no other non-operating expenses are given. Then what we write? We subtract non-operating incomes. Non-operating incomes. Let's see what are non-operating incomes which are given here. We have computed this profit, hai na, gain on sale of investment. That is non-operating income. Gain on sale of non-current investment. How much? We have computed 40,000. So this 40,000 will be subtracted. There is one more in working note, machinery account we have prepared. In machinery account, there is a gain on sale of machinery 50,000 rupees, hai na? Gain on sale of machinery, so that will also come. Gain on sale of machine, that is 50,000. Both are subtracted. No other informations are given, so let me do the total. Okay, just a minute. 1,12,500 plus 2 lakh. Plus 78,750 minus 90,000 is equal to 3,01,250. 3,01,250. This is known as operating profit before working capital changes. Okay. Now we need to adjust some current assets and current liabilities. So adjustment for working capital changes. So let's see, we will begin with current liabilities. Okay, so let's see, in current liabilities only trade payables are given. Trade payables are decreasing, so decrease in trade payables by rupees 2 lakh. Decrease in trade payables by rupees 2 lakh. It will result in outflow of cash, children. Hai na? Let's come in current assets. So in current assets, inventories are given. There is an increase of 2,50,000 in inventories. Increase in inventories. And when to buy 2,50,000. And when there is increase in inventories, it will result in outflow of cash. 2,50,000. Okay, dear children, outflow of cash. And a cash is going out. Then there are trade receivable. Increase in trade receivable is also given. And a increase in trade receivable. ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, लेट सी हाउ मच, 6 लाख माइनस 1,12,500, 4,87,500. सो इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल मीन्स डिक्रीज इन कैश, इजंट इट, है ना. सो इट विल बी आउटफ्लो एंड 4,87,500. Fine, all the points are over. The tax is not given, so there is no need to pay tax. Let me do the total. Hai na? 4,87,500. So, children, it is coming negative 6,36,250. We will put bracket. And what do we write? Cash used in operating activity. So children, let's begin the second activity. The next activity is cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activity. What do we write in investing activity? Non-current assets and non-current investment. For your simplification, I am writing here. Non-current assets and non-current investment we write here in investing activity. We have prepared machinery account. So let's come to machinery account first. In machinery account, machine is purchased for rupees 10 lakh and sold for rupees 3,75,000. So purchase of machine 10 lakh, we'll write here, purchase of machine 10 lakh, result in outflow of cash, and then sale of machine result in inflow of cash 3,75,000. There is one more thing, non-current investment we have to see. We have prepared non-current investment account. So children, in non-current investment account, investment is sold for rupees 2,40,000, isn't it? So we will write sale of non-current investment 2,40,000. Sale of non-current investment by rupees 2,40,000. All points are over. Let me do the total. 10 lakh minus 2,75,000 minus 2,40,000. So it is coming negative 3,85,000. We will put bracket to show negative value. And what do we write? Cash used in investing activity. And then third activity is cash flow from financing activity. Let's prepare cash flow from financing activity. What do we write in this activity, children? We write shareholder fund plus non-current liability. Very simple. So let's come and check the shareholder fund in the question. So you can see earlier share capital was 20 lakh, now it is 30 lakh. So issue of share capital by 10 lakh. Issue of share capital by rupees 10 lakh result in inflow of cash. Let's see what else is given. Now non-current liability is given and number 2. So let's see what is given in note number 2. Note number 2, debentures are given. Earlier 625, now 7,50,000. So it is increased by 1,25,000. So issue of debentures by 1,25,000. Issue of debentures by 1,25,000 result in inflow of cash. Now we have seen there was payment of interest on debenture also. So interest on debentures, we have computed interest on debentures. How much we have come? 78,750 है ना. So 78,750 is to be paid. So we will put bracket for it. Okay. And no other points are given. Let me check. Yes, the non-current liability and shareholder fund, all points are over. And that is all. Interest on debenture is also paid. And here nothing is given. Okay. So let me do the total. Let me do that total. 10,11,25,000 minus 78,750. So it is coming 10,46,250 positive. 10,46,250 positive, and what we call it, cash flow from financing activities. Okay, is that clear? Now let me do the total of all these three activities. 10,46,250 minus 3,85,000 and minus 6,36,250. So it is coming 25,000 positive. So what we write, we will write net increase in cash and cash equivalent. And then what do we add here? We will add opening cash and cash equivalent. Opening cash and cash equivalent. Let's see how much it is given in the question. Opening cash and cash equivalent. It is given 1,50,000, and closing will be is 1,75,000. So 1,50,000, and when we add it, we get 1,75,000. That is closing cash and cash equivalent. Closing cash and cash equivalent. Okay, dear children. So I hope this question is clear to everyone.